Hello, and welcome back to Banner Saga. Wanna look at it? We need to rest at least once. Why? Well, three would be perfect. Six is the most you can get, okay. Be my tank. No, let's give you that. Never. Wait. You never miss? And never miss with no adjacent allies, but you have 80% to hit, so it wears out? Maybe. Over here. Okay. We like those. Stout as well. And by the way, getting here. One more. Actual sagro. See. Could use some crit. Some armor as well. And puncture. And we still can give you some dodge. Now, what are you have? What do you wear now? Minus one aggro. This one break. Yeah, I'll give it. It seems as simply as that we need more, how many we can get. I took you the wrong title, but doesn't matter. Let's give some crit. That you die too often. Okay, I heard someone trying to get into my place and was unsettling. So maybe we don't have to. Once, twice. Once. We need to rest at least once. You find Oli at the edge of the light, staring at the godstone. Mind if I join you? Hard to find space around here. Just keep your voice down. That vicious, wrinkled fiefdom won't share any of his drink, and my head hurts. In the distance, Spar takes a moment from lazily turning his lungs spilled for Oli, a wildly inappropriate gesture. Run out of your own brew? Was my flask when that whale thing shattered the frozen ocean. You hear the things coming out of my mouth? There is no way to live either. Oli stares blankly into the distance. What's your drink of choice? What's yours? Yolk's milk? Who cares? Never mind me. You know how some men can't handle their drink? I can handle being dry. Makes my head hurt. That seems like a problem. Never has been before. Would want to take in all this majesty clearly. I haven't been this sober since I was 13, locked up in Borsgard's cell. He gets a faraway look in his eye. Rums my potion. Poison? To answer a question. Believe it or not, I can't even throw these axes worth a damn, dry as I am. But get me a free drink in me and I see bright ribbons in the air. Wait, You see lines of light? Am I right? Showing me exactly where the axes are going to go. Usually I keep that sort of thing to myself, but what's the point? Molly, I think you might be spellweaving. Molly straightens his back, as if startled. What are you talking about? Like the menders do. Weaving? Take the kneading who farts lightning and raises the dead, but only when I'm drunk? And you're just using it to throw things better. Molly erupts into laughter, loud enough to make even Spar frown. What a time to be alive, eh, Val? I'll drink to that. Don't ease. You pass Oli your mead horn, and his hands shake as he gulps from it greedily. Oli the Spellweaver! My mom always said I was special. Maybe you're not as bad as they say. Well, who says that? Just take the victory. Yeah, we're leaving. We can't stay any longer. We have to leave. Oh, we are getting closer. Not close enough. Any of you ever tasted thistle berries? Spar blurts out in the midst of a deep and oppressive silence. You all got some grim company lately. I could really go for some thistle berry right now. Others mumble in agreement, but someone passes around enough strong drink to spread around. Soon they're trying to one up each other about what they plan to do when they return to Aberrang. In the mountain, keep focused. They go on for a while, spinning bright yarns in dark places. Thankfully, it draws no attention, but it was right to stay vigilant just in case. It's getting on my nerves. Why is it warmer right here? And why does this part look different from the rest? We won't find out. We're back in Aberrang, right? Darkness lurches upon the dome of light, stretches thin above the city by menders weaving fast stitches. Riots ripple through the slender spaces between people packed tightly together, and the warp lick at your defenses, testing them. Finally sinks in just how many dead rest in Aberrang now. This is really the beginning of the end, isn't it? You grieve. The longship's finally sinking, so to speak. All that's left to do is bail till our arms grow weak. You feel those old nagging survival needs scratching at your foes. Food, water, shelter. Market? Oh, of course, no, nothing. Let's see. Certainly promote you to a heart content. Never miss. Hold on. Able to. How else you can get that? So, in addition to that, he also gains the blood letter. Okay. Anyone else? Good deal, another archer. Okay, she simply doesn't have anything. No, I don't want to get this. That's very good. And resist is even better for you. I don't really like using people. Okay, but I'll... Wait, I can give you... I can give you everything. Okay, great. Sure. Do we have anything for 15? No. Who has this? Free break. Market. Okay. Sign for the funeral. They came from all parts of Arboran carrying their dead. An enormous longship the king won't be needing anymore was hoisted up to the Black Rock Plateau. Never mind the hustle, this is tradition. Arranged within the longship, many hundreds of bodies rest, ready for the afterlife, ready for peace amongst the stars. Their struggles are over. You hear all of this from the orator declaring the last rite, trying to set the longship ablaze. Oddleaf looks at peace amongst them, just one of many. Such a thing is heartbreaking. You wonder if sacrificing herself to protect you was part of her plan all along. You breathe heavily, but refuse to cry. The fires are lit. And special bundles laid along the ship's edge tint the flames in different colors, a gleaming rainbow rising toward the sky, and a bridge for brave souls. Imagine the ship drifting out to sea as the fire burns slow. The solemn audience begins to pile stones and soil atop to perform a traditional tumulus. Give a speech for a caravan. Those who knew and believed in your banner, you raise it high. The exact words drift from your thoughts as soon as they're said. The rest of the caravan graciously cheers the ending. The gods would weep if we did not outlive them, and we outlive them still. Now it is we who speak for the dead, the names and the deeds, and gods be damned, they will not be forgotten. Alo puts his hands on your shoulder. His eyes are red, some combination of drinking and grieving, but there is a smile on his lips. I can only imagine how hard all this must be for you. I didn't know Oddleaf like you did, but it hurts my heart that she's left us. Still, I can say stay sad. Well, look, I don't see the dead. I see all those who live on instead. Willow stands quietly beside you, deep in thought. You can't help yourself from miming, can you? Willow, slightly embarrassed, as if you caught him indulging in a vice. I'm sorry. I hope I didn't come off as disrespectful with what I said. I have a hard time putting it to bed. When I was a boy, my grandmother was a famous seer in a small town. I was in awe of her. She claimed the gods never died, that they still spoke through her. Others would come from far away to hear their fate or feel close to them. Sometimes I would listen through the wall to the amazing things she told these people, even though it was forbidden. She knew. When she died, she told me a secret. She said she made it all up. I got upset. I called her a fraud. But she explained that just because she made it up doesn't mean it wasn't real. The stories we tell are just as real as the things we see and feel, she said. Then she died. I remember those last words clear as a bell, and I began to make up stories of my own. Eventually, it became hard not to see the world as a story. And you're always writing one in your head. When I felt afraid or upset as a child, it helped to imagine myself as someone else reading my story. Like the gods who were looking down and seeing they can create things as well. Anyway, I'm sorry about all the rhymes. I'll try to keep them more appropriate moments. I stand quietly beside you, deep in thought. I guess it's time we move on. I suppose we must. The mentors shouldn't be left alone on the walls, and there's already a murmur spreading through the class of not enough food to go around. Sometimes it feels like too much. The true hero comes reluctantly. Though we move on now with suffering feet, our hearts will forever be incomplete. Part of the city smolders since the riots, matching the mood in the lower wings. Supplies are scattered, impossible to tally your portions since the funeral. Boarding seems necessary for the future, and you're afraid the other clans in Upper Moon feel the same. If nothing else, we should set the predicament from here on out, I suggest. Combine and ration the remaining food tightly. Trust overcomes. Some are relieved to place that burden on you. Others insist on keeping a watchful eye on the stockpile. Mentors are spread out evenly along the walls, each overlapping the light created by the next. Guards with distant expressions stand watch between them. Around their feet are piles of warp, dredge, and mend alike. They're starting to scale over the bodies on the other side of the wall, says Zephyr. Some small disgust in her voice, as if to prove the point. Amanda yells when one warp twice in the field. Hurry! Becomes Zeph. Shield wall? I think we find like so they are 12, 14, you are 11, 15. So yeah, I think I'll. More. Are we really fine? Plus free to all talents, what do you equip with? Plus free to all talents. Oh, he's level 9. Equipped with. Give him that. So old man equipped with this little. Oh. Shun. Has this. Maybe I should give you something else. I'll give you this. Only because he's level 13 doesn't mean he has to get something. For level 13. Not everything is good. Oh my god. Keep the warp away from the menders. Rook is first, then is this guy, then is this guy, then is Canary, then and him, okay. He'll be instantaneously hit! Oh, goddammit. Keep it low. And she shoots. So you stay here. Doesn't really matter. Just go. Straight. God damn it. Why it changed from. She is poisoned and bleeding. Where is it now? Rook. move you somewhere. I can move you here so you can start with his armor. It doesn't matter. This guy is next, so like, oh, I can't get it. Yep, this guy is next. I want her to move. We'll kill him. He'll kill him. Yep. I'll pick him over here. Of course. Get over here. No, you're supposed to focus on the horseborn. Could work probably. Nope. Ah, he'll get an eye. She is the biggest threat. She by herself can deal 6 damage per turn, just like that. Give me her. And we need to replace Rook, I think. Oh, maybe not. I would like to replace you though. Okay, this is fine. We can kill the Stone Singer fast. He crit for 8! Ow! How? Don't you dare. Can you stop? There. And you... Oh, you're not dead. What happens to you? You're weakened? Stay here. He's still alive. Oh, he resists! He keeps resisting! Okay, I see it now. There's still this guy. Okay, I don't think he matters. Now he does. We still need to protect her. Ah! We need to protect those two. For level 14, one can help but think unconditionally when wearing this weathered green cap. Wasn't he maxed out? I think he was maxed out. Sometimes I have to wonder about humanity. We're probably holding the rules and all the class can manage is to rob and kill each other. Captain, my menders need more protection on the walls.
You have as many men as we can spare, Falcao. The rest are in the streets. Our barang isn't worth saving if only killers and thieves remain.
Even if my father were here, he would have little control over the city now. I have even less, but I am certain I can find men loyal to my father's manner. Put me in command on the walls.
Are you certain? I can guarantee no safety here.
If there's a time for me to lead, it is now.
They look up to you, you realize that whoever is put in charge of the walls may be in serious danger. The walls are yours, Ludin. Your father would be proud.
My father was a lot of things, but proud of his son is not one of them. I'll send word to loyal men and keep them understanding.
Days.
Hey fella, 7.5 days. Yes? No, 8.5 days. Oh my god. I'll say stop. Okay, and that's gonna be this for today. Now, thank you very much. Stay alive and see you soon. Bye!